What if this doesn't work out? What if I suck at this? What if people laugh at me? What if people don't accept me? What if people don't like what I have to say? Hi guys, my name is andiswa mojapelo and welcome to my channel. If it is your first time here, thank you so much for joining me and for watching this video. I really hope that you enjoy the content and you decide to stay. We chat about all things related to money and adulting in general. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming back, and I really hope that you enjoyed today's conversation. So today, guys, we are chatting about why we are so afraid to fail. Why are we so terrified of not succeeding and allowing that fear to actually stop us from doing the things that we want to do? Now, I'm going to tell you what inspired this topic. So I've been receiving a lot of feedback from people about the content, how it's impacting them, and my personal favorite, how it's motivating them to have conversations in their circles and with the people they love that they wouldn't otherwise have because of some of the things that we chat about here. And that really, really excites me. But there's also another component that I want to address, right? And that's the comments that say, I'm so glad you decided to start. You know, I've been meaning to start as well, whether that's start a YouTube channel, a side hustle, a business, whatever it is that you want to embark on. But there's a lot of comments about, I can't believe you did it. You actually did it. And I've been meaning to do it as well. And, you know, because of X, Y, and Z and time and resources and all of these other things, I haven't been able to do it. And yes, these are reasons, but when unpacking this and actually engaging in the conversation, I found that one of the underlying reasons for this is actually the fear of failing. We are so terrified of not achieving the things that we want to achieve that we end up not doing them at all. When we weigh them against, will I succeed? Will I not? We just don't do it. And I thought this was so interesting because one of my greatest fears is failure. That has been and continues to be, although very less now, one of my greatest fears. What if this doesn't work out? What if I suck at this? What if people laugh at me? What if people don't accept me? What if people don't like what I have to say? I'm sure this sounds very familiar, right? But I also grappled with that for a very long time until I got to a point of saying, you know what? This is never going to go away. How do I manage it? And that's what I want to share with you today. The three things that have really helped me manage my level of fear, and also just do it afraid. Just decide to go ahead anyway, even though I'm scared. Because guys, we are all scared. Typical example, even if as I was doing this video, I was asking myself, should I do the video? Should I not? You know, does this align with the rest of my content? Will people find it valuable? You know, I did a video previously about dealing with a pandemic failure in university. It got less views than my other content. Does that mean that it's not worth it? And that's just an example that we all go through this all the time. We are all scared. We are all afraid. The only difference is that we decide to do it anyway. And I just didn't get to that point. I had to work hard on it, very, very hard on it. And these three things that I'm going to share today really helped me in giving me a foot up. And also constantly, even now, because I do have fear popping up now and again, it really helps me face fear in the face and be like, I'm going to do this. I'm going to try this. I'm going to dare myself and I'm going to put myself out there because it's so, so important if you want to achieve some of the things that you want to achieve. So now, what are these three things? The first thing is to realize that the only way to get to it is to get through it. And there are no shortcuts, right? And this is coming from a person who really likes to plan, prepare, project, look at all the figures, look at everything on paper, look at all the scenarios, look at the risks and everything, right? Before I make a decision. But the reality is that sometimes we spend so much time and energy in that process that we don't end up doing it. And there are certain lessons that you are only going to learn. There are certain things that you're only going to realize on the battlefield. When you actually jump in and start doing it, that's when you're going to get those key lessons that you need to get in order to improve your craft, to improve your business, to improve your channel, to do all of these things. And there's no way around it. Now, I always look at people that I admire who have done some of the things that I want to do or I'm doing or who have achieved a level of success in what I aspire to achieve. And I'm always like, gosh, you know, they speak from such a point of wisdom. I wish I was there. I wish I was also reflecting on certain things with such patience and understanding. And I've gotten to realize that they didn't just wake up there. they had to go through things in order to get there, you know. They had to go to the battlefield, get those scars, get those lessons. And that's how they got to the point where they can now speak from a point of wisdom. So there's no shortcuts. You have to do it. In order to get better at what you want to do, you need to start, and then you need to be consistent. You need to practice, practice, do it, do it. And then you will get better at it. You can't learn from someone's experience. I always refer to this, especially about speaking in front of the camera or speaking in front of people. The only way you get better at it is if you practice, and if you do it over and over and over again, you begin to become more comfortable. You begin to learn more about yourself and how you like to articulate what you want to say and all of those things. So there are no shortcuts, right? You need to go through it. You need to gain your own experience. The second thing I want to address is that of validation, right? The way that we seek validation from other people in order to put a stamp of approval on what it is that we want to achieve, that can be a huge deterrent on what it is that you want to go for. And that's why we are scared, right? Because what will they say? Will they approve? Will they like it? You know, what if they don't like it? And before I speak on this point, I just want to say that I'm not saying that you don't need any validation, because you can't run a business if you don't have customers. It's difficult to start one if you don't have potential customers. And you can have a channel and no subscribers, but if you want to create impact, you need people consuming your content, you need people watching your videos, and you probably need people subscribing. So I'm not saying you don't need anyone, but there's something that someone once said to me in a conversation that really changed the way that I view validation. And they said to me that, Andiswa, it's not about finding 100 people who think your idea is okay. It's about finding 5 people who think it's flipping amazing. And I was like, say what now? And they were like, no, it's not about finding 100 people and getting all of them to think your idea is okay, your channel is okay, your content is okay, and all of those things, and your business is okay. It's about finding 5 people who are like, oh my God, where has this product been all my life? You know, why am I only discovering it now? And once you find those 5 people, it's just a matter of finding 5 others and 5 others. And what I've learned as well since starting these things that I'm afraid to start is that those 5 others also help you. What do I mean by that? So I have about 5 people, maybe a bit over 5, who are not only subscribed to my channel, they also share all of my videos. You know, and if they are not commenting, they are sharing, they are giving me ideas, they are supporting me, encouraging other people to watch my videos, and all of those other things. Not many people, less than 10 people do that for me, you know, about 5. But those 5 people have really helped with keeping me motivated, helping me spread the word, and all of those other things. And they've been so valuable. And obviously, all of my subscribers are valuable, and everybody watching this video is super valuable. But the point I'm trying to make is that if you can find those 5 people who are getting an immense amount of impact from your idea or what it is that you are creating, then home run, right? Because those people are going to help you push the message forward. And you can also be part of the 5, and then you only need 4 others. And then if you are married like me, you've already got 2, and then you need 3. I'm joking. But the point is that just find someone or some people, a few people that are crazy about your idea, that think that there is value, and then push and soldier on, beat that fear, face fear in the face and say, nope, not today. If 5 people think this is great, there must be 5 others out there, and I will pursue this. And the last one is realizing that if you want what nobody else has, you need to do what nobody else does, okay? And what basically that means is that if everybody is afraid to try this thing that you want to do, and that's why there's a lot of value in it, then you can't be afraid. You can't be exactly like the people who are not doing what you want to do. If I, as Andiswa, have a vision and a certain level of impact and a certain kind of impact that I want to have on people, and I feel like not enough is being done in that space, I can't be afraid. I can't be one of those people who doesn't do anything about it. I need to be one of those people who does something about it. And that is very, very important. And the same can actually be said about finances. If you want to live in a certain way that nobody else lives, or most people don't live, it means that you need to do something differently. You need to make different decisions. Because if you make exactly the same decisions like everybody else does, it means that you're going to achieve exactly the same results, and you don't want to be there. So guys, those are the 3 things that have really, really helped me. Focusing on those 3 things has really helped me. Finding people who are immensely passionate about what it is that I want to do, and believing that there are others out there. Secondly, knowing that if I want to get better at what I do, I just need to make more of these videos. I just need to speak more. I just need to interact more. I need to do more research. I need to learn more. And there's no way around it. I can't copy and paste somebody's wisdom and experience and think that I'm going to come in here perfect as ever, knowing exactly what to do, how to articulate myself. No, I'm going to make mistakes. I'm going to stumble. I'm not going to do it perfectly, but I'm going to work at my craft and eventually I'm going to get there. And lastly, knowing that if you're sitting on something brilliant, whether it's an idea or content or whatever it is, if you want to be that person who makes the change, you can't be doing what everybody else is. If everybody is afraid to do certain things, then you need to be the person who's not afraid. You need to be the person who is going to try. And I'm by no means saying that it is easy. It is flipping difficult. I do it all the time. I'm just like, oh, will this work? Will it not work? But I push myself. Why? Because I know what I want to achieve. I know the impact I want to have. And I know that in order to have that impact, I need to get up and I need to face my fears in the face. And I haven't always been like this, guys. You know, I've been afraid. I've been scared. I've been terrified. I still am sometimes, but I do it. And the point I want to get across, I mean, if you don't pick up anything from this video, is just do it afraid. Just try. Just attempt it. Just put yourself out there. You know, take the leap of faith and actually try. So please let me know in the comment section if there is something that you are afraid of that you want to overcome. And also, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give me a huge thumbs up and do consider subscribing to this channel if you haven't, so I can see you in the next one. Bye.